charge you.
You know that you're the love of my life, so I'm excited for this.
I love you for so many reasons, I don't even know where to begin. You light up my world, you make me feel like I'm the only person on the planet when I'm with you. You take care of me, love me, adore me, and I you. We truly make the best team. I don't know how I ever thought my life was complete without you. You look after me and take care of me in the most effortless and perfect ways. I don't think that I will ever be able to express how grateful I am that I found the love of my life. I can't wait to travel the world, try amazing food, drink awesome wine, and have a family and live forever with you. I promise to always be by your side, in good times and in bad. I promise to be mild and understanding when faced with disagreements. I promise to always give you the benefit of the doubt and know that you always have our best interest at heart. I promise to be your rock, your home, your shoulder to lean on, but most of all, I promise to be your best friend. I know I'm not perfect and I fall short many times, but the love that I have for you is the closest thing that I've felt to perfect. I can't wait to spend the rest of our lives together, and I love you.
Megan, from the first time I met you, our love was instantaneous. I remember asking to see you again after our second date for the third consecutive day, and you asked me if I was sure because you thought I might get sick of you. My response, don't be weird. That day still hasn't come, and the love that we share has been pure and effortless, and I know it won't always be as easy as the first week, but I am certain there is nobody else in this world as perfect for me as you are and will be. Your passion, energy, and spirit make me whole. You are radiant in everything you do. I love the person you are, the person you will grow to be, and the couple we are together. You are truly my best friend, and I see my vows more as privileges than promises because I get to live them through with you. I promise to always love you, support you, and hold you as my number one priority. I will look for mutually beneficial solutions rather than compromises when we disagree. I'll remind you each and every day that I love you and walk with you hand in hand no matter where our journey takes us. I love every breath you take, every word you speak, and every song you sing. I will love you unconditionally, without hesitation, for as long as we both shall live.
I'm Megan, give myself to you, Mike.
I'm Megan, give myself to you, Mike.
On this, our wedding day.
On this, our wedding day.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst of times.
Through the best and the worst of times.
Through the difficult and the easy times.
Through the difficult and the easy times.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I have given you my hands to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Mike, your turn. I might take you, Megan, to be my wife.
I might take you, Megan, to be my wife.
I promise to walk by your side forever.
I promise to walk by your side forever.
And to love, help, and encourage you.
And to love, help, and encourage you.
In all that you do.
In all that you do.
I will take time to talk with you.
I will take time to talk with you.
To listen to you.
To listen to you.
And to care for you.
And to care for you.
I will share your laughter and I will share your tears.
I will share your laughter and I will share your tears.
As your partner and best friend.
As your partner and best friend.
Everything I am and everything I have is yours.
Everything I am and everything I have is yours.
Now and forevermore.
Now and forevermore.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
We come here today to witness, honor, dance, laugh, and celebrate the love that these two have created. Now that Megan and Mike have given themselves to each other, by the promises they have exchanged and the powers commissioned in me by the state of California, it is my distinct honor to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Michael Ray Nodal.
You want to do, baby, I'll do anything. If you want to go, baby, let's go. If you want to rock, I'm ready to roll. If you want to slow down, we can slow down together. If you want to walk, baby, let's walk. Have a little kiss, have a little talk. We don't gotta leave it all. We can lay here together, stay here forever. Oh, 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 oh. If you wanna see that Italian tower leaning, baby, we can leave right now. But that's too far, we can jump in the car and take a little trip around town. We know that California is nice and warm this time of year. Baby, say the word and we'll just disappear. If you wanna go, baby, let's go. If you wanna rock, I'm ready to roll. If you wanna slow down, we can slow down together. If you wanna walk, baby, let's walk. Have a little kiss, have a little talk. We don't gotta leave it all. We can lay here together, stay here forever. Oh, it's a big world for a boy and a girl, letting go of it all, holding on to one another. Oh, but there's a whole nother world to discover under the covers. And if you wanna go, baby, let's go. If you wanna rock, I'm ready to roll. If you wanna slow down, we can slow down together. But if you wanna walk, baby, let's walk. Have a little kiss, have a little talk. We don't gotta leave it all. We can lay here together, stay here forever with all of our loved ones forever. Stay here forever. Oh, 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 yeah.
So true love is hard to find. People spend their whole lives searching for it, and when it happens, it's just, it's incredible. And I was talking to Mike. He called me the night after, or the day after he met Megan, and was just so excited. And I could tell in his voice that there was something different. Like, he had never spoken to anyone about, like, anyone like this. And I just had this feeling that there was, that this was it. And he did too. Like, you told me. So then, like, turns out the next day, he says, like, oh, I'm going to see her again tonight. And I'm like, oh, how was that? And he's like, even better. And the next day, sure enough, like, he spends 3 full days with her. And I think that that just hasn't ended. Like, it's wonderful. And so I had the opportunity to meet Megan for the first time in Santa Barbara. And when I met her, she, like, everyone knows, like, Megan is electric. She is just a shining star, and she lights up a room. And just such a wonderful person and sincere heart and so talented. Like, your voice is incredible, and it's amazing that you're able to just go up there and sing in front of everyone. It's really beautiful, and I'm so excited to get to know you more as the years go on and we grow together, and really, really looking forward to that. But Mike... I love Mike. I wouldn't be who I am today without Mike's influence. I met Mike for the first time in 4th grade. Halfway through, he comes into class and he is just this, like, studly cool kid, like, surfer with puka shells, like this. Like, everyone, honestly, everyone wanted to be him. And all the guys, like, were kind of envious because all the girls were just, like, all over him and just super excited. And this is before girls even liked guys. Actually, I think it was right when girls started liking guys. And over that year, I got to know Mike, and 5th grade hit, and him and I were just inseparable, best buds, and it hasn't changed. Like, Mike is someone who... I'm going to put this down. I'm shaking a little bit. Mike is a true champion of kindness, and this is something that my dad has kind of, he coined, and it's really, really important, and I think that that's one of the strongest attributes that someone can have. And Mike really embodies that. He is such a kind person to everyone he meets, and he is so cool. You are very cool. You're like the epitome of cool. And like, I don't have enough good things to say about Mike. Like, he is just, well, he's my brother. Like, I think of Mike as someone who I will always know. I will always like be with. He's the first person I call, and he's incredible. So now, to kind of wrap this up, because there's a few more speeches, you two together is just wonderful, and you were made for each other. Like, ever since the beginning, we knew that. There hasn't been a misstep, but when Mike and I were young, we used to play Tony Hawk Pro Skater. And
I still do.
And okay. And there was this one song, it was by Public Enemy, and there was this verse in it, and it says, "Treat it like soap on a rope." And we never knew what that meant. And honestly, since fourth grade to now, it has changed so many times in its meaning. But it is so, like, I feel like it's, I'm just gonna leave you with that. Treat it like soap on a rope. No, okay. I'm not gonna leave it like that, because I feel like you guys are thinking about it in the wrong way. So what that means is, like, no matter what, like, if things happen, just, like, you know, pick it up and keep going. Like, it's awesome. Okay. Well, I'm glad I've warmed up the audience. I think Lexi's next.
So, I think we can all agree an amazing event just took place. And I think we all know what that event was. The presidential election. So I just thought, instead of a speech, why don't I just go around and ask everyone who they voted for and why they voted for them. So, Megan. Okay, I'm sorry. I just wanted to tease Megan. Okay, hello everyone. I'm Lexi Butzko. I am Megan's best friend. I've known Megan for about 9 years now. We've only been best friends for about 7 of those, because for the first 2 years, I think we both were just kind of like, okay, you can only have one token freckled face girl per friend group. That's just how it works. We didn't want to mess with the status quo. But no, we met through a dance. Two guys that were friends asked us both, and we were kind of forced into friendship. So when we first met, we were on this double date thing, going to a Padres game. Super awkward. Like, we had nothing to say to each other. We didn't know who each other were. We were both so nervous. Like, so nervous. We both go to use the restroom. We're like, we haven't eaten all day. We need to eat right now. What are we going to do? And we both look at each other, and at the exact same time, we say, let's get some chili cheese dogs. That sounds delightful. And Megan, this was the first time I realized she loves chili cheese dogs. She eats these things every day. But we were too embarrassed to eat them in front of the boys we were with, so we sat there and bonded over these chili cheese dogs. And there and then I realized I met my soulmate. I met my true love, my best friend, my sister. So that being said, I've seen Megan go through her fair share of frogs. Not fair share, just a couple, I mean. No. So I've watched her, I've been supportive, but I've just always known that they weren't the one. It wasn't who she deserved, who she was meant to be with. And I kind of remember having conversation with her before she met Mike and being like, you just need somebody who's like Justin Timberlake. And she was like, explain. And I was like, you need somebody who is entertaining in all aspects, who's smart, funny, keeps you on your toes, is just, yeah. So fast forward, I don't see Megan for like a week. She comes to me and is like, I've met somebody. And I'm like, okay. And she's like, no, Lexi, this is so different. And I'm like, okay. And I'm like, well, obviously it's been different. You've been missing for 5 days and you haven't contacted me, because they have this 5-day date. So I go to meet Mike. She finally brings me to meet him. And I just remember thinking like, oh my goodness, she was right. I have never seen two people more comfortable together, more in love, just at ease with each other. And I was just so blown away. I was just like, she met Justin Timberlake. Woo! And I loved Mike from the beginning. I loved the way he treated my best friend. She deserves the world. But we never really had this moment of like, we get each other, like we connect. Until we were on one of our many dates that I would attend with them, because I'm their designated third wheel always. And it's like silent in the car, and Megan's like, Mike's gonna play a song. And I'm like, cool. Plays Phil Collins, the Tarzan song, sings the entire thing to me. And I'm like, dude, okay, you can marry my best friend. I get it, I understand. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is that I love Mike and Megan so much. Megan is like a sister to me. I didn't have a sister, and she's my person, and she will always be my person. We get each other, and I am so happy she found her Justin Timberlake. And to leave it off, go best friend, that's my best friend. Oh, okay. So this is to Mike and Megan and the rest of their lives together. And to all of you guys, I love you all. Cheers.
You know, speaking of the Justin Timberlake thing, I gotta say, he's even got the hair. The cool, he just needs some like cool like frosted tips and... But, yeah, next couple months we'll work out with your stylist. We'll get it done. Anyways, I'm Luke. I'm Megan's brother. Anyways, and you know, Megan's my oldest friend. A lot of siblings don't always get along super well, but Megan and I were always just like two peas in a pod. Like, we always just got along incredibly well. So I always just, you know, loved her and even liked her, like a lot. And, you know, because I liked her so much, I always make sure that any guy that she, like, brought around or liked at all, like, I just hated. Yeah. Like, I just really, like, made sure, like, if there was any flaws, like, I would really exploit them, like, really tear them down. So, yes, and obviously when she called me and told me about Mike, I was like, all right, like, bring it on, like... he gave me a run for my money. You know, I worked for it. There was a while there where I was able to like fend him off and be like, nah, like you suck. I don't really like you that much. You're not even cool. But it was difficult, and I can really say now I'm very happy to have him as my new older brother. And it's... No, he's a great guy, and they both made excellent choices in each other, and I'm very happy for them both. That's it. Yeah. Love you too, Megan. Oh, don't you dare.